Well, there's two important things to determine compatibility from a donor to a recipient. And the most important is blood type. Generally speaking, if you're a blood type O, you can donate to anybody. If you're a blood type AB, you can receive a kidney from anybody. If your other things like A or B, there are some different issues there, but essentially blood type is the most important thing. If your blood type doesn't match, then you're going to reject the kidney right away. The second thing are antibodies. And when we talk about antibodies, we talk about so-called HLA antibodies. And these are a bunch of proteins that are expressed on all your cells that allow you to differentiate self from non-self. And so when you put a kidney into somebody, it has its own set of proteins sitting on the cells, and your body will recognize it as foreign. And if it recognizes it as foreign and they have antibodies against it, preformed antibodies against it, it'll reject the kidney right away. And so that's the other thing we test for, is whether or not that recipient has antibodies. As far as paradonation goes, one of the problems we have is even when people come in with a potential living donor, only about a third of those are compatible matches. And so what we do in that case is we put them into a pool. We have our own internal pool, there are regional pools, as well as now a national paired kidney donation network that involves about 100 or so centers. By doing that, we hope that we can identify other incompatible pairs where we can swap donors. So for example, we have a pair where the donor is a blood type B, and the recipient is a blood type A. They can't donate to each other because of the blood type. What we do now is we go into our pool and we identify another pair where the donor is blood type A and the recipient is blood type B, and we swap. So now the B donor can donate to the B recipient and the A donor can donate to the A recipient. Two people get transplanted, they both get living donors. So that's the basic setup for a paired exchange. That can go on ad infinitum. If you find more than two pairs, you can do more. Well, basically what happens with these living donor transplants is the donor and the recipient go into the operating room at the same time. And once the recipient team decides we're good to go, we can implant this kidney, the donor surgeon will then basically remove the donor kidney by putting a couple of staples across the artery and the vein, taking it out of the body, and then at that point it's passed off to the recipient team. And what they do is they basically flush the kidney with a physiological solution to help preserve it, put it on ice, walk it next door, and then sew it in. And that's really the big advantage, is that there's no cold time. You don't have to take the kidney, remove it, put it on ice, stick it in a box, transport it on an airline. All those things add cold time to it, which can prevent the kidney from working right away. The living donor kidney, it basically within 20 minutes of removing the kidney, you're sewing it in. And because of that, almost 100% of these kidneys are working within 24 hours.